Hello, my name is Robert Alleyne and I'm the founder of the Dog Owners Club. Today I'm going to be talking about a very important issue, one that I get asked about a lot, and some of you will probably already be having problems with, which is recall, getting your dog to come back when you call it. Why won't dogs come when we call them? I think there are several reasons why this happens, but the key is we start it right from puppyhood, convincing our puppies that actually lots of other things are much more interesting than us. If you look at dogs as an animal, whether it's wolves or living in a social group of animals, look at any other social group. As soon as one calls the others, they all come straight away. Nobody refuses to come. Nobody says they're busy doing something else. So why doesn't that happen with our dogs? And I think it's because right from when they're little, we teach them they don't necessarily have to. And often when we call them, it's not really very interesting. So as soon as you get your puppy, start grilling into it what its name is. If there are several people living in the house, practice being in different parts of the house, calling the puppy backwards and forwards, and always encouraging it and rewarding it with something that it would want when it gets to you. So if it's a puppy that's very motivated by people, make sure you give it lots of hugs and kisses and strokes. If it's a food-motivated puppy, when it comes to you, give it a stroke first, then give it food. It's ideal if you can always try and remember to stroke and touch the dog before you feed it, so that it learns to look forward to the stroking and the touching, because they're a precursor to the food. If you give the food first, what you often find then is by the time you want to touch him, he doesn't want to be touched anymore because he's busy eating. So try and get into that routine. But by calling him back and forth and back and forth lots of times every day, you're conditioning him that whenever somebody calls him, he should get to them as quickly as possible. But I think where it all really starts to go wrong is when we start taking our puppy to the park. And there's so many things that are more appealing than us. So we take our puppy out on its first walk. It meets somebody on the street it's never met before. They come over, they make a huge fuss of him. We stand there letting them fuss him because we want him to be social. But he suddenly starts to realize that all these people out there, they're obviously just out there waiting for him. And that as soon as he comes out, they all want to pay homage to him. So very quickly, he becomes really interested in other people. He's jumping up, he's grabbing their clothing, he's clawing their legs, doing all these sorts of things that we don't want our puppy to learn. When I take my puppy for a walk, I don't want strangers to stroke him. We tell our children, don't talk to strangers, don't have anything to do with strangers, don't take sweets from strangers. With our puppies, we do exactly the opposite. And then we wonder why our dogs are obsessed with strangers. Then we get into the park, and if we're brave enough, we let him off the lead. And we let him run around, playing with other dogs, running up to strangers, all of whom want to give him loads and loads of attention. But he's also learning that actually in the park, we are really the least interesting thing there. Everybody else is much more interesting than you. Then at the end of the walk, you clip him on his lead and you drag him home while he's having all that fun. So we encourage him to play with other dogs because we want him to be social. We encourage people to make a fuss of him because we want him to be social. What's he really learning from us? Very little at all. So of course that dog doesn't want to come back because all we represent is the lead being put on and him being dragged home. So the way to make your dog interested in recalling is to convince him that you are a resource that's worth being involved with. So my puppies, right from when they're little, I play lots of tugging games with them. I encourage them to become obsessed with a toy that is a training toy. It's never left lying around. This is a toy I take out, I play really enthusiastically with him, and then while he's still really enjoying the game, I put it back. And I do this several times a day. So the dog becomes obsessed with trying to get that toy. Very occasionally, I'll let him kind of pull it out of my hand and run around with it for a little bit. So he believes that if he keeps working at this, eventually he's going to get that toy. Then I take him to the park and I try and find a time or an area where it's relatively quiet. There's not too much going on. If he starts to wander away, I call him back and I offer him the toy. If he comes back, I play with him really enthusiastically again with the toy. I don't throw the toy away because as soon as I throw it, I've given all the power to the puppy and he may choose not to bring it back. So I play with him, I tug him, I take it away. If I call him and he doesn't come straight away, he's distracted by a leaf or something he's found on the grass, I immediately start heading off in the other direction. And then I call him and I want him to look around and see that I'm miles away. And suddenly he's panicking, not literally miles away, obviously, because I won't even be able to see him, but far enough away that he says, oh my goodness, I shouldn't have turned my back on you. So I'm trying to build his confidence in coming to me, but also undermine his confidence in not coming when I call him. Sometimes I'll hide behind a tree or hide behind a bush where I can see him, but he can't see me straight away. And what I'm trying to teach him is what his mother would have taught him. If you don't keep up with me, you're probably going to get left behind. So you best work hard at staying with me rather than me following you. When he meets other dogs or people, if it's people and they ask if they can fuss him, most of the time I'm going to say no, because I don't want to encourage him to believe that strangers are really interesting and fun and exciting. So if they ask if they can stroke my puppy, I say no. They say, is he nervous? I say no. They say, why can't they stroke him? And I say, because he's my puppy. If you want a puppy to stroke, the rescues are full of them. Go and get one from rescue, stroke your own puppy to your heart's content. But I don't want you luring mine away. And I don't know why we're so happy to tell people they can't touch our children, but we're very reluctant to say they can't touch our dog. I don't get that. My priority is to protect my dog. If he meets another dog, I'm going to encourage him to be what I think is social, which is literally just a meet and greet. I want him to sniff that dog, say hello. The other dog sniffs him, says hello. I'm then going to call him away, and then I'm going to play with him when he gets back to me. So I always want him to be thinking, I am the most fun that he can possibly have. But I know a lot of owners find this a very difficult concept to accept because they love to watch their puppy playing with other dogs and roughhousing, and they think, oh, it's so lovely to watch him doing that. And for me, I say, well, that's up to you. If you really enjoy that so much, you can't bear the thought of missing out on it, then by all means do that. But you're probably going to have a dog who doesn't recall because he's learning that other dogs play with him in a way that you never do. You're never going to be rolling around in the grass and tugging him with a stick in your mouth and chasing him back and forth like the other dogs will. So he learns that you're much less fun than they are, and you will pay the price for that at some point in the future. So if you want to do that, that's fine. But then you really can't complain if the dog doesn't recall because you allowed him to learn that everything else is more fun than you are. So play lots of exciting games. What puppies want is play. And if you can convince them that they can get to have that play with you, there's less reason to run elsewhere to have it. So those are my key points for getting your puppy or your dog to recall. Make yourself much more interesting. The more interesting you are, the less interesting everything else becomes. In another video in the future, we'll deal with dogs who already aren't recalling and how to try and bring them back. But this is how to set your puppy up for success. Thank you very much. If you like that video, please click like. And if you'd like to subscribe, please do so. And if you then want information on future videos, click the little bell button next to the subscribe. Thank you.